On June 14, 1993, Lillian Myers gave birth to a baby boy with the name of Charles Murray. Charles's mother committed grand larceny in 1934 and suicide a year later. Charles Murray was then given to a couple of the names Mary Ethel and Fred Edwards. They renamed the child to Edward Wayne Edwards. His foster mother passed away at the age of 36, and his foster father was an alcoholic. In due time, his foster grandmother would come to adopt him. At the age of 7 years old, Edward was sent to Parmadale Orphanage, where he would constantly receive severe punishment for being a bedwetter. It was at this time that he decided that he would commit crimes for attention. After running away 15 times, he was finally taken out of the orphanage and expelled from school. Once 17, Edward signed up to be in the Marine Corps, but went AWOL when informed he couldn't go into combat. Edwards began to commit armed robberies across the country, stealing several cars from dealerships in the process. He had four known wives, his last wife being Kay Hederly, mother to three of his known children. Outside of his crimes, Edwards had many relationships and affairs. He was attracted to feminine girls and would convince them to leave town with him. Some tendencies he had included being controlling, being physically abusive, and cheating on his partners when bored. He began to commit homicide in 1977, shooting Judith Straub and Bill Lovaco on Lover's Lane. In 1980, he kidnapped, tortured, tied up, and stabbed Timothy Hack and Kelly Drew. These two specific events became known as the Sweetheart Murders. The final murder that Ed Edwards was proven guilty of was in 1996, where he beheaded Danny Law Glockner, collecting $250,000 from the man's life insurance. Eventually, April Belasco, his own daughter, tipped off the police about her father's involvement in the Sweetheart Murders case. Edwards was given two life sentences on the account of murder and was able to withstand trial. He died on April 7, 2011 from natural causes. He would have been executed by lethal injection on August 31st of that year if he hadn't passed. We characterized Ed Edwards as a sociopath due to his origin, capability of empathy and guilt, inability to hold a steady job, and impulsive and erratic behavior. We also labeled him as a hedonistic killer because he was very much into controlling others and having power over them, but not the sexual aspect like a power control killer. He is an organized killer because he's charming, socially adequate, socially competent, dates around, and follows his crimes. Some of his tendencies were lying and impulsivity, and he committed a lot of his crimes for the attention it brings.